Hello, this is Broyar, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Civilization 6, playing as the Khmer on a Deity difficulty. And just before this video started, I was sitting here looking at this symbol, trying to figure out what it was. I mean, this is our monk. It's one of the new units in the game with the new patch. And I'm trying to get like some sort of ear here, some sort of weird animal or something like that. And then it hit me. I was like, oh, it's a fist hitting an open palm. And I was like, oh, that makes more sense for a monk. So there you go. That's what that symbol is. Other news, we have found another continent besides our own, or at least another landmass besides our own. I don't know how big it is yet, but we definitely found something else, and it's already got a river, which is excellent for us. River and lots of grassland. This is where we're going to settle next. Somehow, some way, this is our next target. So on that note, we are going to go ahead and I think take care of getting a settler out. I'm hoping this warrior monk, maybe go ahead and send the archer over. Is enough to take care of the crossbowman over here. We may need another unit. Don't really have any other really good strong units at the moment. So yeah, I think we're just going to go ahead and do a settler and see if we can get over there. If we get a city over here, then honestly at that point, we can start pumping out units to go ahead and take out these barbarians at that point. So, Mr. Monk, you're going to go ahead and start heading this way and get over to this little landmass as we continue to explore around it to see how big this thing is. Anything else? No, I think we're good. Oh, really? Really, really? You stuck a barbarian encampment right there. Okay, it's just a spearman. Okay, for one, I did forget to reactivate you. So we're going to send you over here, help take that thing out before we head you over to the land over there. And that's going to be fine. That's some good land over here so far. Lots of space so far. Poland. We haven't actually found any of you guys yet. Oh, hello, wait a minute. Did you just invite us to one of your cities? Yes, you did. Oh, right there. Okay, well, that's within striking range. I might be the first person we go after then. I'm sorry, Poland. I mean, we've met some other people, but you're the first one that we've actually found your landmass for. Looks like Brazil might actually be friends with us. Sure, we'll be friends with you for now. You are not going to be our first victim, I don't think. So, I am okay with that. Sure, we'll be friendly with you. Now, supposedly they did fix a little bit of a bug that prevented you from being able to be allies with the NPCs. So we might try that out here shortly. Research, what do we want to go for now? We can go for those Domreys. That's an idea. Really start pumping out a bunch of those, go after Poland right away. And I feel like we've got to be super ultra aggressive in this game. Getting some industrial zones would help us as well. No, let's do it. Let's at least make it an option. And we get out a couple of these with a couple of those warrior monks. That's going to be a pretty strong unit, I think. Strong force. Alright, Mr. Monk, let's get you over on the other side. That's a lot of landmass. Now, we did find somebody else over here, but that's a lot of space there that we should be able to at least put something over here to get us a jumping off point. I'm going to keep friends with you for now. We'll save your victimization for later. I mean, honestly, I wasn't really planning on going like necessarily a domination victory. I was going to maybe try one of the other ones, but a domination victory with monks like to the end of the game, that would be kind of fun and cool. Like we're just a very like religious, you know, civilization who's just our warrior monks, you know, spread our religion by force if necessary across the rest of the world. That'd be kind of cool. Hello, Mr. Caravel. Eesh, we need to get our money situation figured out so that we can start upgrading these guys. I think I'm just going to run away for now. Hopefully you do not chase me at the moment. We could be friends with Scythia. Well, again, since Poland appears to be our first target. Well, we'll go ahead and stay friendly with you for now. We're mucks. We mean peace until we don't. I think two or three monks. At least two. Definitely at least two monks. And then maybe three or four archers and three or four Domreys. That might be something like that. Might be a good solid force to go with. All right, so let's go ahead and just, I don't know, whatever, get you somewhere. Archer's going to go ahead and continue on after this monk over here. All right, so you're fine. There he is. We can go ahead and take that counter, though. Probably we'll just go ahead and send you back home to get you healed back up, though. I don't want to lose my ships yet. Defensive bidding, city strength. Don't need either of those at the moment. That's going to be fine. Again, we're still going to go towards monarchy. Because monarchy will let us... Oh, not monarchy. That's not the one I wanted. I want theocracy. Because that'll let us buy all of our land combination units with faith. Plus a discount on faith purchases. Yeah, no, I definitely want to go towards Reformed Church. That seems to fit the most with what we're doing at the moment. So on that note, let's just go ahead and select it and see what we need. We'll be picking up Divine Right along the way, which is fine. Getting civil service first is good. Feudalism, we would need to get some farms out, which we're having trouble doing at the moment. But, I mean, honestly, let's just start worrying about the civil service first, and we'll go from there. We could just plop down a bunch of farms over here, I guess. We do need to get one over here by this... aqueduct, though, and we can at least get one going out. So we'll look at getting maybe a builder or two here shortly. We can get another one on this wheat pretty easily. That would get us three. So yeah, a pair of builders would help us out. Right, let's go ahead and stop you there. That's going to be fine. You're going to go ahead and come back home to get you healed back up. You are going to keep on making your trek over here. Probably land you over here and just kind of run you up that way. I think that's going to be fine. Oh, that's still currently undefended. Who is this? This is, is this Brazil? No, Brazil's green first, then yellow on the outside. I'm not sure who this is. Oh no, the outer one's the primary. I was just looking at ours. Our outer one is the primary yellow. So yeah, that's probably Brazil. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, now that I see more of it, definitely. Ooh, swordsman and crossbowman. That's a little trickier. I mean, we are effectively the same strength as these swordsmen, right? Oh no, he's 36. We're only 30. Oof. Yeah, that's not good. Well, let's go ahead and get you over here then. Get you on here just to do some exploration. Maybe we need to at least get a city up before we worry about going out combat-related stuff. Go ahead and heal you back up. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and move you over here as well. That's going to be fine. Let's go ahead and get you up on this hill. Some jade over here. It's not really... Oh, wait, we've already got that luxury resource. It's not really going to help us in that regard, but it's all right. Brazil's actually a pretty potent target on this particular landmass. Probably should send somebody up here to see what's up here near Poland, because if we can get another city up there nearby them, that might help us out as well. So we can purchase another warrior mount. I think that's fine. I mean, at some point we may want missionaries and things to get some relics and stuff. But until we find some actual other religious units, I'm not going to worry about the missionaries at the moment. So, nope, war monks it is. Alright, warrior. I guess you're just gonna chill here. It's gonna be fine. Go ahead and just make your way down to the coast somehow. Just gonna come over here. I think I'm just gonna plop you up on that top of that hill to help defend this monk. And I think this monk's just gonna do a little bit of poking around. Ooh. Brazil's right there. Let's see. What am I looking for? Settler. Why did that not work? Alright, so here's the deal. We can stick a city over here. And then pop a holy site down here to push the borders out if we want any of this land. Just to kind of give us some more cushion and stuff. And that would actually be fine. So like a city here or on this forest. See, where would be a good place for an aqueduct? Actually, city here, aqueduct on this forest, farms around it. I mean, there's only, I think this is this flat right here. No, that's hill. So we'd have to wait till we get the hill tech in order to do that. City here, aqueduct here. We'd only be able to do two farms, one of them right away on this plains, this wheat right here. Could be all right. On the other hand, we could settle on the jade. Would give us a couple options for aqueducts in this direction, but honestly, an aqueduct off this oasis would have quite a few options. And I think I'm leaning towards that. I mean, I don't think we need to... I think settling on top of the jade is actually going to be a fine idea. Yeah, I think I like that. Because I think we can do aqueducts off of oasis. Let's double check. Aqueduct. Or not aqua. Oh, it's E. I said aqua. Yep, oasis. Perfect. So I'm thinking I'm leaning towards that. In fact, we're going to go ahead and drop a pin down right there. And that's going to be just whatever. City 1. With the idea being that this right here would be... we'll just do like a square for a district. Would be the... Aqua, I guess. Something like that. Farms all around it. We'd only be able to do two. But honestly, that's quite a few farms. I think that's going to be pretty good. Actually, then where would we put the holy site to push out borders? Not sure, actually. We could pull the city back away from the river. Put the aqueduct here. Still have three farms around it. And then put the holy site right there. Push out those borders, get us a little bit more space. Because which of our things is it that... that needs to be next to the river? I can't remember. So the city just needs to be next to the aqueduct. The aqueduct just needs to exist for us to get the faith. Misspoke. I think it's the... I think it's under you. Okay, so it's the holy site that needs to be placed to the river. So the city doesn't need to be placed to the river, the holy site does. So I'm actually maybe thinking that might be better. Let's just put this down here. We'll call that C2. And then maybe this one right here, what's it called, A2, as the other option. I mean, we could still put the city here, the aqueduct here, and just do three farms, and then the holy site next to it, which actually is probably fine as well. I don't know, we'll look when we get closer. Getting a trader out to get us some money would be good. Getting a caravel out would be good. Getting some culture going would be good. Getting all the things. I don't don't know what to do, what to do. Let's get a trader. We know we're going to need one of those. All right, so you can't really do much here. We're just going to pause for a second. We may jump you across the river momentarily. Brazil's not going to be happy with us settling that close, but what's he going to do? It's a river. There's another one down here that we would be looking into settling at some point as well. There's a scout. We may jump across here to go after you a little bit. It's a little dangerous. Oop, another river down here. Man, we can completely surround Brazil over here with some fairly nice cities. Really don't want to be aggressive against these guys until I get my my city over here, though. Let this guy get some healing. If he gets damaged. Yeah, I don't think I want to take that engagement. I'm going to jump you across here. If he wants to attack me across the river, that is fine with me. Yeah, there's another good spot over here. Goodness, yes, I like it. Which means that Brazil may be a very strong second target. Actually, that may should have been our first target, come to think of it. Alright, so you're going to come down this direction. I think, I don't know. If I put the city here, just put the holy site there, aqueduct here, and just use these three, four farms. That at least gets the city next to a river from the get-go. It does mean the aqueduct's not as strong, but that means we don't have to wait for the aqueduct to be, you know, growing very strongly. So ultimately, that's probably the better bet. Also gets that city within range of this wheat if we need it. 1, 2, 3, gets it within range of the whales, gets it within range of the cattle. Pearls, yeah, I think that's a good city. I think that's the better spot. So we'll go there, settle on top of the jade, and I think that will be fine. You're going to come down here and help support this guy, who is going to just fortify up and hope that crossbowman doesn't sneak over here and start beating us up. Oh, hello.
New Zealand's fjordland. That same childlike feeling, long lost, a pure, unadulterated...
Yeah,
a
city down here is starting to look very, very appealing.
The road to Milford Sound was good, but this good?
We shall have to see. What to do with you? I mean, we do need to probably get a caravel at some point, but honestly, we're going to need more ranged melee than melee... Sorry, ranged... ships than melee ships is what I meant to say. Can't really do catapults because there's no point because our Domreys, we can't upgrade them to Domreys. Start doing a couple more archers and be ready to upgrade them to crossbowmen, and that's going to take gold. So let's knock out a lighthouse. It's going to get us a little bit of gold, a little bit of housing, a little bit of food, and ultimately it's going to buy us time until we get these 9 more turns and to get another population anyway, so I think that's going to be lining up perfectly. A little bit of gold is going to help us out in the long run. In fact, after we get military engineering, I think we're going to go for the crossbowmen. Oh, no, no, no. Not good at all. About to lose us a monk. I don't think you can get over there close enough to draw his attention. You can't get close enough to that guy. We're going to swing you down here. I don't think it's going to matter. Goodness. We're going to get beat up by barbarians before we go after any of the other civilizations. Alright, you're just going to sit there and heal. Yeah, there's nothing for you to do. We're just going to put you on top of this hill. Maybe if that goes, guys come close again. With being slowed down in that forest, maybe we have a chance to get a pot shot against them. Ah, it's frustrating to lose another monk right there just because of the stupid caravel that came out of this thing, probably. Oh, I didn't mean for you to go into the ocean yet. I was not paying attention to the fact that you were going to jump out there that quickly. Ah, goodness. All right, well, you're going to link up with him. Nope. Whatever. I don't know why that was really weird, but anyway. You're gonna do nothing against that thing, but whatever. Goodness. This is bad. Stupid. No, stop moving. That's not what I wanted you to do. I wanted you to link up. I meant to link you up. Captured. Where did it go? Man, this is bad. This one caravel is going to stop us from doing anything good. That is very frustrating. I don't know where that settler went. And I don't see it down there. We're going to get you back over here for now. Maybe that spearman can help us take that thing out over here. I don't know where... It says it captured him. Did it just kill him? Maybe it just killed him. Which is really even worse. Go and get another monk, but there's really no safe way to get him across the water, apparently. Goodness. I was feeling pretty good about stuff. But not no more. All right, we're going to go ahead and put a cut in here. Things were looking, you know, kind of good. We're about to get a city here in a couple turns that was going to be really, really helpful to us, but that is not going to work out at the moment. So I don't know if we can go find our settler or if we're going to have to make another one. We're probably just going to have to make another one. But anyway, if that will happen next time, I do appreciate you watching and I hope you join me again. Thank you and goodbye.